may call me Mr. Davenport, sir.
And where are you living at the moment, Mr. Patterson? Are you still at 5818 Sinclair Lane?
Yeah, that's where I stay. It's not where I live. They say I gotta live somewhere, so I say that's where I live. That's not really where I live, that's really where I stay. Feel me?
So, who lives on Sinclair Lane?
My mother.
You live with your mother?
I just told you that's not where I live. That's where I stay.
Got it. I stand corrected.
No, no, no. You're not listening. I don't like repeating myself, and I hate being misquoted. Misquoting leads to gossip, and I don't do the gossiping. I ain't got time. I could be out here getting my money. Matter of fact, ain't that what your job's supposed to be? Supposed to be helping me get myself straight so I can get my money right? That way next time I say, where do you live? I can tell somebody where I live instead of where I stay.
How often do you think you've stayed with your mother?
You mean after she raised me? Probably off and on since she got out of the hospital the first time. She got HIV back in 2010, so I feel like I move in, help her out, but real talk, I was really needing a place to stay because I lost my place when me and my girl broke up. So I just got out again. I was like, boom, head over east, help my moms, just clear my head out.
I'm sorry to hear about your mother's illness. That has to be hard for you.
She take a gang of pills, but she all right. I ain't tripping.
Look, I don't want you to feel pressure to talk right away or at all today. I'm here to listen.
Look, I know I ain't got to talk. I know this. I can sit this whole session in silence if I want to. I ain't got to say. I just got to see. That's the mandate, dummy. But if I was to talk, it's a safe space for real though, right? Like I can say whatever kind of messed up stuff I want to say. You can't use that against me. Get me canceled, nothing like that. You know, if anybody see me out here, you ain't my therapist. Matter of fact, you ain't a therapist at all. You my client. I'm here to do work on your ride, your bends. I'm detailing it, yeah.
As long as you don't present yourself as a threat to others or yourself, I'm required to hold in confidence what you say here. So you squeegee?
Yeah, I squeegee. I sell loose ones. Sell that world's finest chocolate. I ain't rap, ain't got no horse, but I'm enterprising. You know anybody need a bus pass? Nah, I'm playing. You don't know nobody catch no bus for real. Not here, at least. Maybe New York or Chicago, but people like you, you don't catch the bus here.
People like me.
Only people like me catch the bus in B-more. People like me hate riding that shit. I seen my pops on it a minute ago. He ain't say nothing. Probably thought he dreamed it because he was so busy leaning off them bukes. But either way, we hit the intersection. He pop up out of his seat, push his way up out the back of the bus, yelling, "Back door!" Now this dummy banging on the glass like he losing it to the bus driver let his stupid ass out in traffic. If something like that was to happen to you on a bus in Manhattan, probably because it's part of some kind of experimental theater joint or something. But when that happens here, it's because we over east. And I don't need that. As soon as I get the L's from the court, this suitcase, I'm getting a little ride. I'm gonna start hacking, doing Uber again. You know, black people started that rideshare hustle, feel me?
Really? Care to tell?
Oh yeah. See, back in the day, black folk couldn't get no cabs because of racism. So it was always other dudes in the neighborhood that you could reach out to. They run you back and forth to the store, to work, see your side chick. Yeah. But even when cabs would take our money, they commit what millennials call microaggressions. Like, say a certain cab company take Jimmy's out in the county. You couldn't hail Jimmy's, you had to call them. And even when you called them, They wasn't coming to the city to pick your black ass up or drop you off. Unless there was another fare going somewhere back out to the county. Now, who the hell got the time and the mental dexterity to organize those kind of auto vehicular gymnastics? Not me. And you ain't got to worry about none of that with a hack. Because with a hack, we come find you. All you got to do is this, maybe walk back a little bit, and I got you. But Uber, yeah, Uber should have been us for real, for real. If we was in charge back then, we'd be talking about Uber in the past tense. Nah, but y'all don't want us to have nothing. Maybe one or two, but no more. Declarations say all men created equal. But the Bible prove otherwise. You know much about the Bible? Like the story of Noah? That isn't about the ark?
I think I'm familiar. Noah and his sons.
That's it. Noah had them sons. They was on the ark. You think they'd be close and cool, but Noah still cursed one of them to generational servitude forever by putting this mark on him. And now the mark is how everybody knew he had the curse. And this causes inequality between the brothers and all of mankind for all of eternity. And that mark is supposed to be where black people come from. We're supposed to be the cursed sons of Noah's son. And that mark is our delicious, dark, world's finest chocolate skin. But, you know what's really messed up about that? Noah, he ain't have the curse his son. Or any of his son's brothers could have stepped up and advocated for their brother. They chose not to. You know why? I'll tell you why. Because how you know how high you sitting unless you got somebody to look down on.